Hello dear viewer. Today I want to explain how to master FULGORA'S scrap mechanic and build a simple yet efficient base. I've seen so many content creators struggle on this planet and my first steps and base design also resulted in a total spaghetti mess. So strap in and let me show you how you can set up a base without a massive headache. FULGORA has two resources, scrap and oceans of infinite heavy oil. Scrap can be recycled with a recycler or by hand. The resulting 12 possible items are holmium ore, the most important, rare and precious element needed for all FULGORA exclusive items. Ice, stone, solid fuel, steel, gears, copper wires, concrete, batteries, red circuits, blue circuits and low density structures. But in order to produce all desired items we need more, like for example iron and copper plates or green circuits and plastic. The trick is to recycle the initial 12 items again, to break them down into their subcomponents. Recycling items like holmium, ice or stone doesn't produce new materials, but others will. Gears will turn into iron plates, copper wires into copper plates, red circuits and low density structures will give us plastic, blue circuits and red circuits break down into green circuits. You see, by recycling items once more, or in some cases even twice, we gain access to all resources that are needed. But what about liquids? The sole purpose of ice is to melt it into water, and since heavy oil is an infinite resource, we can use oil cracking to get light oil and then petroleum gas. Lubricant is very easy to make, just from heavy oil alone. You can even make sulfur and sulfuric acid, and by using solid fuel and light oil, we can make rocket fuel. Conveniently, we now have access to all the three components necessary for rocket launches already. But here comes the huge problem. You will always get these 12 initial items and some are more useful than others. My first instinct was to separate them, put them on belts like a main bus and build a base as usual. But if you don't consume every single item, it will eventually fill up its entire belt and then clog up everything. So you have to recycle items to get new materials, but also make sure to remove excess items to not clog up any belt. It's a huge pain in the ass to set this up, especially early on. And by the way, hats off to Voop for this amazing planet and scrap idea. Here's my advice. Do not try to separate all items. Instead, become King Sushi Belt of planet Norvis, the first of his name, King of the Scrap and Heavy Oil and the Lightning Storms, Lord of the Five Planets and Protector of the Solar System. Embrace the Sushi Chaos. We start by mining scrap and in some cases it makes sense to use trains to bring it to a larger island with more space. Now build an area of recyclers to process the scrap. We put the initial 12 items on a single belt and create a loop that will end up back at our recycling machines. The shape or length of the loop doesn't matter, you can use whatever space you have on your island of choice. You can start with a small loop and increase length at any time later on. We now merge this belt with the incoming scrap belt. Set the splitter's input priority to the non-scrap side, in this case left. This is really important, if you don't do this, your sushi belt loop will eventually come to a standstill. We don't want to let new scrap enter the economy unless there is a void to fill. See what happens if you forget this setting. The initial 12 types of items that made it through the sushi belt loop will be recycled, which removes 75% of its components and will yield in some cases new items like mentioned in the first part of the video. For example, we now see green circuits and plastic and iron on our belt. This sushi belt loop will consume scrap and recycle forever without coming to a standstill. You might think, we don't have any production yet, shouldn't we stop this recycling process until we are done setting up production? Isn't this a waste of resources? Well, if you use a splitter and filter and store the most important item, holmium ore, it isn't a waste of resources at all. Holmium is the bottleneck for all production on FULGORA. All other materials, even blue circuits, are meant to be recycled and discarded. So let this loop run and recycle as soon as possible. Build chests and set reasonable limits for handcrafting to have items ready when setting up production or to build a mall later. But how do we take items from the sushi belt? Let's use ice to make water as an example. Using a regular splitter with filter setting doesn't work. The ice now has to leave the sushi belt, so if consumption of water and ice is too slow, the belt will back up and block our entire base. Instead, you can use an inserter to take items from the belt. Unfortunately, it's possible that the inserter misses some of the items due to inserter timing. Here you can see some ice that the inserter didn't grab. That's why using a combination of splitters is my preference. Make a small blueprint like this. The first splitter uses a filter, but the second one just uses output priority. This way, items can merge back onto the sushi belt if the outgoing belt is already full. Don't be confused by the filter of the third splitter. I like to use output priority with a deconstruction planner so that items don't end up at the splitter's unused output. It's not necessary to do this at all. Now we can just start working on FULGORA'S technologies and science pack. We don't have to worry about chests overflowing, wild spaghetti and belts backing up, stopping all production. Our recycling and sushi belt is running and running and running without maintenance and is accumulating precious holmium ore while we are working. To set up production of holmium solution, we use our filter blueprint to get holmium ore and stone. We already have water, so this is very easy. We can now grab the holmium ore from our storage chest and feed it onto the belt. In order to continue, we have to produce holmium plates. All we need is holmium solution and assemblers. Let's put the plates on the belt, similar to a main bus. To prepare ourselves for the production of superconductors, we need light oil. So let's set up heavy oil cracking. Superconductors are made in electromagnetic plants and we need copper and plastic, in addition to holmium plates and light oil. Let's now produce electrolyte, which requires heavy oil, holmium solution and stone. Of course, we are using our splitter blueprint again. Next up, supercapacitors. They are also made in electromagnetic plants. We require electrolyte, superconductors and holmium plates. Additionally, we have to take batteries and green circuits from our sushi belt. Let's use some belt side loading because this recipe requires 5 different ingredients. We put the supercapacitors on a new belt and now we are ready to produce the electromagnetic science pack. We require electrolyte again, holmium solution and the supercapacitors. Additionally, we have to make accumulators. But that's easy because we have batteries and iron plates on our sushi belt. And here we go, we are producing FULGORA'S science pack. Now of course you also want to set up production of electromagnetic plants. In order to do so, we also have to set up the production of refined concrete. But it's not a big deal because we already have water and all the other ingredients are on our sushi belt. And at this point you could set up interplanetary transportation and ship the electromagnetic science pack and the electromagnetic plants to Novus. And this is what the base looks like with the sushi belt. I think it's very clean, but there's one issue. And this is nothing to do with the sushi belt, but holmium ore is always the bottleneck on FULGORA. So how do we get more holmium ore? Well, why not double the rate of our scrap recycling? So let's add an additional block of recyclers with a very short loop. On the right side, we use a splitter to output holmium ore to our main sushi belt. It's the sole purpose of this new recycling block to output holmium ore. Everything else will be trashed. And now that we doubled our holmium production, we can now use speed modules to increase the holmium solution production. This also enables you to use the new recycling loop to produce modules, maybe even work on quality. You can also move the chests for handcrafting and a potential mall to the new recycling loop. And if you need more space for more sub-factories, just increase the size of the main sushi belt loop. Okay, I hope this video was helpful to bring some order to your FULGORA base. The next FULGORA video will probably be about quality production and modules. If you have other ideas, let me know in the comments below. And if you like this content, please consider subscribing. Thanks, bye.